Hello friends, today I will discuss the welding. Here, so we will see the what is the necessity of the welding, what is the definition of welding, types of welding, resistance of welding and applications. What is the necessity of the welding? If you want to have the joining of the two metal pieces, or if you want to add or connect two pipes together, or you want to join two rods, we need a method called welding. Then what is the definition of welding? It is nothing but a process of joining two metals by applying high heat and high pressure . So then, what are the types of welding? So here I will take up only electric welding classification. Here there are two types of weldings. One is called the resistance welding, the other is called the arc welding. Arc welding is nothing but it uses resistance for its welding. And in this case, two metals to be welded or joined together, and then current is passed through the elements to be welded, and the depending upon the contact area resistance, the heat production depends, and the quality of the welding also depends on the heat produced. And also this resistance welding depends upon three factors. One is the square of the current flowing through the specimens to be. Next, coming to the arc welding, here an arc is formed between the electrode and the metals to be welded. Means at the joining point of the two metals, the arc will be formed via an electrode. So arc is nothing but a current carrier. By using that current, the welding will be done. So that is called arc welding. Coming to the resistance welding methods, so here there are several methods. One is spot welding, the other is seam welding, projection welding, butt welding. Again, butt welding is classified into two categories: upset butt welding, the other is flash butt welding. Similarly, there is a classification of arc welding like this: metal arc welding, carbon arc welding, atomic arc welding, argon or helium arc welding. So let me discuss here about resistance welding. The resistance welding depends on three factors. One is the square of the current flowing through the elements to be welded, and the value of the current that is flowing, and the time for which the current is passed through the elements, and also the contact resistance of the two metals to be welded. The general arrangement for resistance welding is like this. This is the welding transformer. It will have the primary windings like this. And these primary windings will be connected to the supply, and the secondary will have the thick wires like this. These are the secondary windings of the welding transformer. The specialty of this secondary winding is it provides the high current at low voltage. One winding is connected to the fixed electrode, while the other winding is connected to the movable electrode, and each electrode will have the clamp facility like this. This is one clamp, this is another clamp. The purpose of these clamps is to hold the metal pieces to be welded. This is one piece to be welded, this is another piece to be welded. This movable electrode will also have the spring pressure arrangement so that it can be moved with high pressure to the left or right. let us see different types of resistance weldings. Let me consider first butt welding. This butt welding carries the two metal pieces to be welded like this. This is the one element, this is another element to be welded. They are brought together with high pressure. So as a result, there is a resistance of contact area here at the ends of these two elements. And once the secondary winding of the welding transformer is connected to these electrodes, this is one electrode, this is another electrode, current passes to the electrodes and then to the elements to be welded like this. So because the contact area resistance is high and the current flowing is also very high, so the heat produced is more. Once the temperature reaches to the welding temperature, then these two metals join together so that forms the weld. Then the power is switched off to these electrodes. And the example for this butt welding is like this. This is one sheet, this is another sheet. They are butt welded, that is, they joined together like this. Next, coming to the another welding method that is called flash butt welding. Here, two electrodes are there and each electrode carry the one element to be welded like this. There is a light pressure applied to these two elements so that there is a light air gap between these two elements. Then these elements are these electrodes are connected to the secondary of the welding transformer and the power is switched on. Then heavy current passes through these electrodes, then passes through these two elements. Because of the high contact area resistance at the joining points, an arc will be formed between these two contact faces. That arc is nothing but also called flash. That arc carries the current, that is high current. Because of the high current, temperature of these two element faces increases, so they melt at the welding temperature. And if we increase the light pressure, then the welding completes and the supply is cut off to these electrodes. Then welding will be formed like this. Here we find the bulging point here. This bulging point do not have any effect on the quality of the welding. If necessary, it can be removed. Example for this is the two pipes. They are joined together with the help of flash butt welding. Coming to their applications, this type of welding is used for alloys with zinc, antimony or bismuth. Coming to the another type of resistance welding, here the electrodes are copper electrodes, that too they are tip type electrodes. So then one electrode at the bottom is fixed while the other top electrode is movable, means it can be moved vertically. And the elements to be welded are kept like this. This is the bottom sheet and this is the top sheet. And here we need welding only at these two points. So the electrodes are also kept only at the desired points like this. Then the supply is given via the secondary of the welding transformer to the electrodes. Then these electrodes carry the high current through these elements at the points desired. So then once the temperature reaches to the welding temperature, these two metals will join together and forming the welding, and then supply will be disconnected to these copper electrodes. Example for this is like this. This is the sheet, and to this we want the bolt arrangement like this. So we need only the at the surface of this nut and this seat. So we apply this spot welding. So we get this spot welding like this. At this we need, at this we need, at this we need. So we have done using spot welding. And the temperature normally for welding for this case is 950 degrees centigrade. Next, another welding is called the seam welding. Here, the electrodes are in the form of rollers, means they can rotate. And these roller type electrodes are connected to the secondary of the welding transformer. And here, the metals to be welded are kept like this. One on the bottom of the roller electrode, the other over this element, another element will be kept like this. And what we want is, we want to have the continuous welding from here to here. So we apply here what is called the series of spot weldings. So that is, already we have seen what is spot welding, means we identify the point and at that point we pass the current, then we weld it. Similarly here, when these two points are at this point, so current passes through this point, so this point will be welded. Next it is moved to the left, then at this point the current flows, that is it's focused at this point, then again it's moved to left, then at this point. So like this series of spot weldings will be done. That series of spot welding is nothing but seam welding like this. And where we get this application? So look at this. This is the seat which is to be joined together. For this we use seam welding. See this point, and I mean this side and this side, seats are brought together, and the rollers, means roller electrodes, are passed through this bottom and top of this seat. So then welding will be done like this. Next, there is another welding called the projection welding. This is the special welding, and here the electrodes that we use will have the large diameter like this, and the elements to be welded also will have the different shape. The bottom one has the flat metal, whereas the top metal will have the curves like this. And we want the welding at these points only, here and at this point, means at the only at the curves. So the flat element or this flat specimen is kept on the bottom electrode like this, and over this bottom element or the specimen, the top specimen is kept like this at the desired position like this. And over this top specimen, top electrode is kept like this. Then light pressure is applied over it, then supply is given to these electrodes so that current passes through these points with high intensity. Here also high current passes, and as a result, due to the high contact resistance here and here, welding temperature reaches, once the welding temperature reaches, welding happens here and here. Then supply is cut off to these electrodes. Then we get the welding at these two points between these two metals. The example for this is like this. This is the flat specimen and this is the curved specimen, and we want the welding here, here, here. So that is projected here, this is projected, this is also projected here, like this, here and here. Coming to the disadvantages of this resistance welding, here we need the high cost equipment, so initial cost is more, and also it needs high maintenance cost. And coming to the advantages of this resistance welding, we do not use any external material to do the welding, so that is no filler material is required. Second is, its heat is localized as per your requirement. And here the welding action is also done very fast. And it does not require more skilled persons. And it can be used for bulk welding production. And it can be used for welding both similar and dissimilar metals. Coming to the application, in general, this resistance welding method can be applied for both ferrous and non-ferrous metals. For related industry videos, you can go through these links like this. Please like this video and subscribe to the channel.